I lived in Nashville for 8 or 9 years at that point, and had lots of songs that were blaring over the radio, but I hadn't yet at that point been a part of a song that really found its home in the voice of the church. And my prayer was, God, I would trade all that in if I could just step into the back of the church and hear something that you had given me being sung to you by people I don't know. And I pray that to God every day. And I prayed it every day for a period of months. And I wasn't writing much at the time. And but in that same season, God brought you guys into my life. And he also brought Reuben into my life. And Reuben and I wrote this song, Forever Rain. And just on a Saturday morning, I woke up that morning, and I knew he was coming over, and I knew he was really just an incredible talent. And I didn't want to disappoint him, so I wanted to have an idea going when he showed up. And so I went into my room and just sort of started thinking about all the things I would want to say about God. You are good, there's nothing good in me. And really just sort of wrote out all the things I wanted to say about God, just about who he is. And so when Reuben came over, I said, well, I have these verses. I don't know what to do with it. And he goes into a God space when he's writing a song. So he wasn't even next to me. He was sort of behind me, sitting in the corner on some stairs. And he started singing, oh, I'm running to your arms, running to your arms. The riches of your love will always be enough. And it was like God was just telling me everything that I was praying for right there. Like, he was saying, like, my love will be enough. Mm-hmm. And so it was weird. It was like he was answering my prayer and the song that Reuben was singing in the back of the room. And we didn't talk much about the song afterwards. Mm-hmm. We went to lunch, and maybe 2 months later, I got an email. And it was just a clip of 5 minutes of audio. And I started playing on this audio, and I didn't know what it was. And it was thousands of people pouring their hearts out at Hillsong Church, so loud that you could hardly hear the music. And I started crying. Mm-hmm. And I pulled my wife in, and that was it. Like, that was, to me, it was like, man, you know, God's love is so abundant and so rich, and he gives us the desires of our hearts. And so this song was really like a major moment in my life. Not that now it's gone on to become a great anthem in the church around the world, but for me, it really is a real personal, like, revelation of God's love for me, and that the passions he puts in us when they're holy and when they're about him getting glory, like those seeds of passion, like he's a plan, and a good and perfect plan for those.